A permutation is a mathematical calculation of the number of ways a particular set can be arranged, where the order of the arrangement matters. In other words, a permutation is an ordered arrangement of items that occurs when no item is used more than once, and the order of arrangement makes a difference. For example, you need to arrange 7 of your favorite books along a small shelf. How many different ways can you arrange the books, assuming that the order of the books makes a difference to you? Since the order of the books is important, you can choose one of the 7 books for the first position on the shelf. This leaves 6 choices for the second position. After the 2 positions are filled, there are 5 books to choose from, and so on. Applying the fundamental counting principle, multiply 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 5040. From the previous example, the product 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is called 7 factorial, and it is written this way. Generally speaking, if n is a positive integer, the notation n factorial is just the product of all positive integers from n down through 1. N factorial is just equal to n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 and so on till you have 3 times 2 times 1. Essentially, you are just subtracting 1 starting from n, and you keep on repeating that until you reach 1. As a special rule, 0 factorial, by definition, is just equal to 1. To apply the definition of factorial, let us evaluate the following examples without using our calculator. For letter A, we want to evaluate 8 factorial divided by 5 factorial. We begin by expressing 8 factorial as 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 factorial. Looking at this one, we notice that we can just cancel 5 factorial in the numerator and in the denominator. So this will just cancel out. And that leaves us with 8 times 7 times 6, which is equal to 336. Now let's take a look at letter B. Let's evaluate 26 factorial divided by 21 factorial. We will write 26 factorial as 26 times 25 times 24 times 23 times 22 times 21 factorial. Since the denominator is also equal to 21 factorial, we can just cancel 21 factorial from the numerator and denominator. So canceling this will give us 26 times 25 times 24 times 23 times 22. And that is equal to 7,893,600. The permutation formula is the formula that you are going to use if you want to find the number of ways an object can be arranged when the order is important and also when repetition is not allowed. That means no item is used more than once. So the formula here is the number of permutations of R items that are taken from N items. You could think of N here as the total number of a set, and R is a subset of the bigger set. The permutation of R items taken from N items is equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial. To illustrate on how we can use the formula for permutations, let us take a look at the following example. You and 19 of your friends have decided to form a business. The group needs to choose three officers, a CEO, an operating manager, and a treasurer. In how many ways can those offices be filled? Now, in this problem here, it is implied that a person cannot be a CEO at the same time an operating manager and at the same time a treasurer. So it cannot also be that an operating manager is also the treasurer. Since we need three different people to fill in each of the offices, therefore, this problem is a problem for permutation. We will use the formula for permutations to solve this problem. Your group is choosing R equal to 3 officers from a group of 20 people. So N is equal to 20. 20 because that includes you and 19 of your friends. The order matters because each officer has different responsibilities. Using the formula for permutation, we have 20 permutation taken 3. 20 factorial divided by 20 minus 3 factorial, which is equal to 17 factorial. To compute this, we will express 20 factorial as 20 times 19 times 18 times 17 factorial. Since the denominator is equal to 17 factorial, we can just cancel 17 factorial from both numerator and denominator. And that leaves us 20 times 19 times 18, which is equal to 6,840. So therefore, there are 6,840 ways to fill those offices. The following is the formula for permutations of duplicate items. You will use this formula here if you want to count the number of ways of permutation of n items, where among in n, p of the items in n are identical, q items are identical, r items are identical, and so on. The formula is equal to n factorial divided by p factorial, q factorial, r factorial, and so on. To illustrate the formula for permutations of duplicate items, let us consider the following example. In how many ways can the letters of the word Mississippi can be arranged? Notice that the word Mississippi contains 11 letters. So therefore, N is equal to 11. Four of the letters are I, so you have four I's here. So P is equal to 4. There are also four S in the word Mississippi. So Q would then be equal to 4. Also, you have two P's. Then we will take R to be equal to 2. So therefore, the number of distinct permutations are 11 factorial, that is the number of all the letters in the word Mississippi, divided by 4 factorial, that is the total number of I's, and 4 factorial is also the total number of S in the word, and the 2 factorial here represents the number of P's in the word Mississippi. Expanding this, so 11 factorial may be written as 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 factorial. We have 4 factorial in the denominator. Now, this other 4 factorial may be written as 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And the 2 factorial will be written as 2 times 1. Now, 4 factorial in the numerator can be canceled with the 4 factorial in the denominator. Multiplying the numerator divided by the product in the denominator, that gives you 34,650.